people say to me, you know, God, it must be a hard job. And I say, no, it's not. If you like riding a bike, it's the greatest job in the world. There isn't a better job in the world. And they go, oh, he's got the greatest job in the world for him. What they haven't remembered is the fact that there's a reason why I like riding the bike, and I know what that reason is.
And dieses Gefühl, einfach frei zu sein, auf der Straße zu sein und einfach komplett frei zu sein. Ja, du bist dein eigener Herr, du fährst und du bist nur einfach nur glücklich.
My brother, he left his bike and his bag and his lock in my mom's garage. I instantly fell in love with riding my bike around the city. It was kind of crazy at first. I got in good shape, you know, and like I was meeting all these cool people and I was seeing all these cool things, so I was hooked.
Ich war eigentlich Läufer, aber konnte nicht mehr laufen und insofern bin ich aufs Fahrrad gestiegen. Fahrrad war die richtige Alternative.
And I know what that reason is. It's the creation of energy. It's the creation of energy. That's why I like riding the bike.
Also, wo bist du?
Ich bin Schulterblatt, aber Arne kommt da auch noch hin und bringt mir eine Funke mit.
Ich war absoluter Idealist. So. Es war für mich ganz klar, dass ich den Job machen möchte, weil ich eben so aus vom Fahrradtourenbereich komme. Ich bin mit meinem Fahrrad früher lange Touren gefahren, sogar aus idealistischen Gründen von hier in die Türkei, weil ich einfach nicht mit dem Zug fahren wollte. Für mich war es ganz klar, dass das die Alternative ist für Autos in der Stadt und überhaupt für den Transport. Autos gehören meiner Meinung nach natürlich immer noch nicht in die Stadt. Ich habe auch, wie gesagt, Bauingenieurwesen studiert und ein Teil davon ist auch Verkehrsplanung in unserem Studium. Und Autos haben einfach in der Stadt und in der zukunftsorientierten Stadt haben Autos nichts zu suchen. Die Stadt gehört den Menschen, die Stadt gehört den Fahrrädern und eine hohe Lebensqualität kannst du nur mit Fahrrädern und mit Menschen garantieren und nicht mit Autos.
When I was 11, I was playing football. And this ball arrived at my feet, and I just hit it, first time. I didn't think, did nothing. And as I hit the ball, the whole of existence stopped and turned to silver. Now I realize I've recreated that experience at 11 years old. but in another form. I was everywhere in the city at once.
Good girl, off you go, princess.
I think it was the next school holiday, or the school holiday afterwards, where I got the sack. They just told me they didn't want my services anymore. And I was shocked, man, because I had no other income, you know? And I thought, what do I do now? And then I went back to the house and someone said to me, well, why don't you, you ride a bicycle all the time, why don't you get a job as a bicycle courier? I got the yellow pages out, looked up couriers, and I found this one, Super Couriers. And so I thought, oh, I'll phone them up. And they said, oh, hang on a minute, we'll put you through. You'll be speaking to the boss. And this bloke said to me, when can you come in for an interview? So I said, well, tomorrow morning? Fine, half past nine tomorrow morning, mate. And this is where immediate, initial, visional judgment falls to pieces. I looked then, as I do now. Can you imagine? He's looking for couriers. I do that before I go in to be interviewed, but by the time I've run up the stairs into the office and da-da-da-da, come in, sit down, Mike. I'm looking for a job as a bicycle courier. You are the face of the company. Do I really want to employ this face? Look at me. Look at me. You look at someone and you go, da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da. You can't help it. It's all vision, isn't it? That's how people make their judgment. Their eyes tell them something and that's what they accept. See you tomorrow morning. Up past 7 in the office. I said, yeah, surely. And I worked for that company for 7 years. 7 years, man.
Nine five.
Morning, Jane. Mate, downtown ferry terminal, ready to rock and roll. Sorry I'm a bit late, dude. Just sort of odds and sods.
That's right. Cheers, mate. Cool.
Sure, chap. Have a good day.
You can have the lousiest day in the world, but that first time in the morning when you get and you sling your leg over the saddle for that very first time, something right has been done.
Eine kleine Subkultur entwickelt, einfach so ein, ja, so ein Happening, größtenteils um zurückzukommen, zusammenzukommen und einfach sich wiederzusehen, sich auszutauschen, miteinander zu feiern, Teile auszutauschen, Fahrräder zu gucken, politische Sachen auszutauschen, sich zu organisieren, sich zu stärken.
Carlos. I'm messenger in Portland for many, many years. I live in a little mountain town of Colorado now. Yeah,
change. Kurieren, so einfach an den Alltag orientierte Lebenssituation, Arbeitssituation versucht nachzubauen und das dann halt in ein abgestelltes Renngelände gepackt mit gefakten Kunden. Und Abholung, Zulieferung. Fahrtrichtung und gewissen Spielregeln und ja, und so wird versucht, wer der schnellste Kurier der Welt ist.
Ours goes to one, ours goes to one. Get out of here. Pedicab! Pedicab!
All right. my rainbow. He's got his two rainbows. And next year, we're going to do it again.
We'll see. Yeah,
we'll
cheers.
Do it again. I love you, man.
Yeah, cheers. I was hoping you would win. I really wanted you to.
To Light Wheels, which was the next stop. It says Light Wheels. They told me I got to go to the first checkpoint.
I hope you weren't slacking off.
No, it's yours to win.
No, I hope you
had
weren't slacking off.
You had to earn it.
All right.
Yeah, it wasn't, all right. It wasn't nothing. Yeah. It was good. It was a good race. Good, it was a wide, long course.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was good.
Let's go for a victory lap.
Cheers, let's do it.
I'm riding.
Yeah, no. Let me sit you in here.
All right.
You got to wave to the crowd and everything.
An London war die nächste Station.
Budapest, Philly, Copenhagen, Edmonton, Seattle.
Amsterdam, Rotterdam, Hamburg, Warschau, Kopenhagen, New York.
It is about, you know, the race and who's winning, but it's more just about seeing your friends every year.
The first messenger event I ever went to was the World Championships in Toronto in 1995. And that really fucking blew my mind. It made me want to bring that to New York. Because in New York, there was nothing like that. In New York, the only time messengers got together was when there was a memorial service. Kids know that there's a crew of us out here looking out for each other. So it's not like you're all alone, you know? You got a family. Yeah, you know, I think it's great that we're promoting cycling, you know, and like there's too many, especially in America, there's too many kids who sit and watch TV all day and they're not getting exercise. They're playing video games, they're watching TV. And if some kid sees a messenger riding a bike on TV or in an ad, maybe it'll inspire that kid to go out and get on his bike.
Ale, ale. New York ist ein Inbegriff eigentlich für die Kuriere und ja, 1000 Leute und King of Messenger ist ziemlich nett. Ja, ich weiß eh noch nicht, wie ich das ganze Zeug nach Hause bringe, weil ich will mir da noch ein Trackbike kaufen und ich habe schon irgendwie genug Räder dabei. Also. Mit dem Fixie kriegst du einen tollen Fluss ins Fahren. Also du bist ja immer am Treten und es fließt alles viel mehr als mit dem Rennrad. Da hörst du auch mal auf Treten. Und der Unterhalt ist extrem günstig. Also du hast die Reifen musst du wechseln und sonst eigentlich nicht viel. Ab und zu mal die Kette. Und hin und wieder mal ein Rahmen, der von einem Auto halt gekillt worden ist.
In New York, it's always been track bike for messengers. It's popular. But I think since the World Championships and people start traveling around the world, now it's kind of got spread around, you know? But it makes sense. It's easy to take care of. And it's a good workout, too. It makes you pay more attention. you're not depending so much on the bike, you're depending more on yourself.
Friendships that you build around the world with messengers. You can basically go any city in the world that has messengers, call somebody up, you don't even know them, just go, yo, I'm a messenger from Copenhagen, can somebody put me up? They're like, yeah, sure. They find a place for you. You don't have to go to a hotel, a hostel, nothing.
Kyle, you're too good to me. I want to take you home.
Oh, please.
All right.
The way it works with a dispatch race is the four riders have a blank manifest. When it starts, they ride out. One goes here, one goes here, one goes here, and one goes here. That way we covered the whole grid.
This is one, two, three, one.
And after a couple of minutes, they gave me a manifest where I had a whole bunch of tags where they said, go from here to here, here to here. And then I have to, like, do routes and call up, pick up, na-na-na-na-na. And they have to write it down on their blank manifest, going from, to, making sure they get the stamp. Like a real day, you know? You have all the daily routines, basically. You have radio problems. You can't get a hold of people. Miscommunication, like, do I take this package or don't I? And can I take this one? And so that's a lot more like if you were at home working. Yes, but I'm on vacation, that's the difference. Later, later. I wouldn't want to see the city from a bus or from a train. Because you don't get the same experience. I love the fact that I can just ride around. If I see a little shop I want to go into, I'll just lock my bike, go in there. If you're on a bus, you have to, like, figure out where to get off. You see the cities from a different perspective than you would as a tourist and didn't know anybody.
a year before I became bicycle courier, I really wanted to, I still do want to coach soccer in the United States. I'd really like to do that. If I had enough money, I'd take a bike and I would just tour the United States on a push bike, going to every soccer, I'd make up an itinerary and go to every soccer tournament I could possibly go to. So I was buying this Soccer USA magazine. I came out, got the key out, bent down to unlock the padlock, and there, lying in a puddle, is a $100 note. A $100 USA note lying in the bottom. So I thought, oh, it's Monopoly money. That's the first thought I had. And I'll pick it up anyway, screwed it up, put it in my top pocket, unlocked the bike, came home. Next time I went across to town, I took it at the money exchange place. I handed it to the woman behind the counter, and she counted me out $125 New Zealand dollars and gave it to me. The cosmic finger has said, do you want to go to the States? You want to coach soccer? Here's a bit of the States, $100 note. But that's not the way to go, dude. This is the way to go. Bicycle courier. Fuck, an American $100 note lying on the bottom of a fucking puddle. Spent the last 8 months thinking about the United States. Yeah, pay attention. The power of the mind. Jagger said, which is what made him Sir Mick Jagger, you can't always get what you want, but if you try sometimes, you might find you might get what you need. Busy? No, he says, it's boring. I said, yeah, well, you get periods like that. Every one of those couriers I regard as a brother. I just do, I just get on with them so well. Yeah, it's a family. I really care about them. All the couriers, there's a Maori. I thought he was Samoan. He's a car driver. And this bloke's coming in the building and he goes, 9-5. I said, yeah. He walked up to me and he just embraced me. And I'm not talking about this stupid fucking white man fucking business. I'm talking about fucking embracing you, boy. I'm talking about fucking embracing you. This bloke embraced me. And I was shocked. I couldn't believe it. I've heard you on the radio, he said. I've been longing to meet you. I said, oh, yeah, right, well, you know, you're busy? And now, whenever he sees me, we just embrace. Anywhere, High Street, fucking Queen Street, and we encounter each other, we just embrace, that's it.
Good afternoon. Yeah, I'm still chilling here. Okay, I will take that double rush. You know, as I'm getting older, I feel I should be back in Botswana because the pace of life there is a bit slow. I can't behave, you know, in my older years. As a developing country, people get crazy like when they're driving because they too have to cope up with the civilization, and I think civilization where it is, you have to be dealing with speed every time. Things have to move a bit fast. Like any other, you know, job, what you put in it is what you get. Basically, that's what the messenger business is all about. You've got to, like, hustle.
Hey, what's up? Only a handful of people I know who've been doing it for more than 10 years. And it's kind of like a day-to-day thing. It's like, it's really, I'm still day-to-day, you know? I mean, I'm working tonight and the next few days because I really have to. It's like the kind of job that you just keep doing it. And like, it keeps you in shape and it pays the bills, but it's not the kind of job where you can save a lot of money doing.
This is my job, den mache ich seit Tausenden, Hunderttausenden von Kilometern. Und ich muss mich durch diesen Dschungel kämpfen und muss halt diese Aufgaben erfüllen. Und dafür kriege ich Geld. In Hamburg 6-7 Stunden, 130 Euro. Wenn man Glück hat, mehr, ein bisschen weniger, aber auf jeden Fall leichter verdienteres Geld. Weniger Kilometer, weniger Zeit. Hier habe ich durchschnittlich 8-9 Stunden am Tag gearbeitet, ohne große Pausen und großen Schnickschnack. Und habe, sagen wir mal, $100, wenn ich gut war. Am Anfang musste ich halt noch ein bisschen Lehrgeld zahlen. Es dauerte alles ein bisschen länger. Hartes Brot.
Alter, ich nehme alles in einen Satz. Ich hab die ganze Zeit gedacht, ich stehe hier. Und ich bin, ja. Dachte, scheiße, wo ist der Fehler?
Ja, fuck it.
Und jetzt, negative.
I'm holding just a Franco for 488 Madison.
There are gonna get the mantles in. Okay.
Rüber. Die schneiden dich nur. Geht überhaupt nicht. Muss schön Mitte fahren und halten.
Aber ich muss sagen, nach den knapp 3 Monaten, ich bin so froh, wenn ich wieder zu Hause bin, in der Zivilisation. Ich hoffe, weniger Autos in der Stadt und mehr Fahrradfahrer. Ich hoffe eine Menge. Also ich hoffe, guck mal, da liegt ein Fahrradsattel, Alter. Das ist ja wohl die Aufnahme vom Herrn. Die Städte, besonders New York, fahrradfreundlicher werden und ich hoffe, dass man als Lkw-Fahrer oder Taxifahrer nicht einfach ungescholten über Fahrradfahrer rüberfahren darf. Ich hoffe, dass viel mehr mit dem Fahrrad irgendwie in den Städten bewegt wird und gehoben wird. Thank you.
There's just something about the energy here, and there's so many people here who are making it. And I know this guy Dexter, who's a bike messenger, he's got one leg. He was riding slow, and some guy came up and hugged him and like almost knocked him off his bike. And he was like, "What, yo, what are you doing? Get away from me." And the guy was like, "Yo, you changed my life." And he's like, "What do you mean?" He's like, "I used to be a beggar on drugs, sitting on the street. And I saw you ride by one day, and it just inspired me to get off drugs and get a job, yo." There's just so many people like that. You're out here and you're doing your thing, and like, you get caught up in the little bullshit that's part of your life, and then all of a sudden you see someone like Dexter and you're like, wow. It's like, what was I complaining about 5 minutes ago? You know, I just see this guy out here who's doing it. Like, I've seen over the years, like 10, 15 guys die, messengers, you know. I've seen girls get really racked up, and it's just like, it's kind of like this, like a big machine, you know, and people get grinded up in it every once in a while.
Last Monday, I'd had a funny time the week before with the football and with a couple of the parents. I woke up on Monday morning feeling less than okay. It felt not quite balanced. Got to work, started work, and about up past 10, 11 o'clock, I'm cycling round through Viaduct Harbour. And suddenly this bloke just opened his driver's door on me. And I cycled straight into it. And there was this sort of silence. And he said to me, sorry, mate. Like that, you know. He may as well just said, have a shit, you know. I mean, sorry, what does that mean? As it happens, I've learned that it isn't wholly his fault. Part of it is me, because if I hadn't been there, it wouldn't have happened. You know, it takes two to dance. It takes two to dance.
In here, 3 weeks ago,
car door was a hole in my arm.
One of our cats got to run to the hospital. Yo, some sage, rosemary, olive oil. Yo, make a good compress, an Indian compress. It takes care of it. See how good it healed? Not even a hole. See this? Ah, car door. Ah. Ah, that's the car door. You hit something, destroy that shit.
When it's your time to leave planet Earth, it's your time to leave planet Earth. You know, whether you're sleeping in your bed or you're getting run over by a bus. It's like, it doesn't matter. You're gonna go when you're gonna go. Yeah. 1 week before the championships, I think my head was spinning with all these different things going on. And every day I was working so much that when I woke up, I had 20 things to do. And when I went to sleep, I had 20 things that I needed to do the next day. So I had been running like this for like 2 weeks. When I was coming down the bridge, I was thinking of like five different things. You know, I wasn't thinking about coming off the bridge.
You're not supposed to ride your bike through the bridge entrance and the BQE. It's like the highway going onto the bridge, but sometimes I ride across it really fast if there's not that many cars. And I sprinted across and one car was coming very fast and faster than I thought. And I realized that they were gonna hit me right on. I jumped up as high as I could. My bike took most of the damage, and my head went through the windshield. I just got 9 stitches. Like I broke the windshield with my head, the front windshield of the car.
What happened was, all of a sudden, all this jumble in my head got cleared out. And like, I was back to ground zero, you know? I was like, I had to stop thinking about the championships for a couple hours, you know? I had no choice, you know? And Amy came and got me, and she took me to my friend on the Lower East Side who does stitches, so I got to avoid the hospital and all that stuff. I had to take a day off the next day, and I had to sit back and relax and say, okay, I gotta take care of my body now, or I'm not gonna make it to the championships, you know? So that was good in a sense that It made me sit and be in the moment, you know? And I realized at that point that we had done so much work and so many cool people were involved that I didn't have to do everything, you know? I could relax a little bit. I could take a day off, you know? It was still gonna happen. Kind of straightened me out in a weird way. As I said to my wife, the only way I can relax is to throw myself through a windshield, you know? It's like, that's what I needed to do to take a step back.
So, ultimately, the rock bottom last fucking word in the whole thing is that it's about energy, man. It's about energy. And the creation of energy. But to create energy, you must expend energy. So you have to find a way of expending energy so that you can create energy. Here we come to the infinite. I reckon the bicycle is one of the finest ways of creating energy it is possible.
Ich würde mich als einen richtigen Etikett-Freak bezeichnen und ich bin verrückt nach Etiketts. Etiketts sind halt intensiver und das Rennen selber ist halt natürlich viel, viel echter. Es ist in der Nacht und es sind illegal, also das heißt illegal, es ist halt auch nicht angemeldet und es ist im wirklichen Straßenverkehr. Ihr kriegt jetzt noch Würfel und noch Geld. San Paolo-Poli war so eine Idee, nehmen wir mal dieses Spielchen Monopoly und können wir daraus mal so eine Live-Action-3D-Aktion machen. Gesagt, getan. Wann nehme San Pauli, macht daraus San Paolo-Poli, 12 Checkpointe auf San Pauli, würfeln, Karten ziehen, in Knast wandern, Geld sammeln.
Ja, oder gleich?
Like, went to the cops. Are you checkpoint?
That oh, fuck!
I was pretty lucky. I got a lot of, you're lucky, get 10 extra. And I just went to jail once, so. I'd never been here, so it's like, you gave me the black and white paper and it's just go.
That's the one, isn't it?
Checkpoint!
Straße an Kast. So it's gotta be that way. Fuck.
Ich werde auf jeden Fall in Istanbul ein Etikett organisieren Obwohl es keine Kurierfahrer gibt, aber ich habe genügend Freunde aus aller Welt, die scharf drauf sind und die dann alle kommen werden.
Okay,
du kannst es machen wie ein normaler Job, ganz klar. Einige machen es auch und es ist auch gut so, dass es auch den Aspekt hat. Aber für mich ist es was anderes, eben keep the spirit. Und für mich steht ganz klar, dass ich meinen eigentlichen Beruf nie machen werde. Dass ich immer Kurierfahrer bleiben werde. Im Herzen, auf jeden Fall. Also.
Packages for $3 and $4 for some of the worst companies in the world, you know? If I wanted to be so politically correct, then I would have to go on a farm somewhere and grow my own food, you know? It's like, if you want to be part of the city, you got to deal with the people that built the city, you know? It's like the people with the money. They're not changing us, maybe we're changing them.
Stand up for critical mass, stand up for your right to free speech, stand up for your right to transport yourself without burning fossil fuels in this city.
And stop riding all day. Go, 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 just go. And at 5:15 in the evening, I stopped the bike. I just stopped. And as I looked up, I was everywhere in the city at once. And I reckon if you can cycle sufficiently enough, for long enough, and hard enough, that you have an overflow of energy, and there's only one place for that overflow of energy to go and take you with it is outward. And then, of course, you become at one with everything. And the people that you meet, you know, they're all so different. There are some that you could spend hours sitting around talking with, you know, and there are others who can't see you go out the door quickly enough, you know. Hurry up and get in a lift. But it's wonderful, you know, it's wonderful. And those ones who can't wait to see you get in the lift quickly enough, those are the ones I like to work on. I really like to work on them, you know. I mean, I really like to sort of, I really like to make them smile. I really like to make them smile. And it's really nice when you get a smile. So many people do jobs that they're not wholly, totally wanting to be there. Then the day does take on some funny facets, some funny dimensions. So the only way to offset that is to be as light-hearted and as undisruptively humorous as you can possibly be. People say to me, what's the big attraction about being a cycle courier? Don't you want to be a motorcycle courier or a car courier? I say, no. They say, well, what about all the road rage? I said, there's no road rage when you're a cyclist. If you find yourself in a circumstance you don't like, you get off the bike and get up onto the footpath and just stand and wait for everything to go away. And then get back on your bike and go on. Show respect. Show respect. You will never, ever be able to outrun a machine. Therefore, defer, give way. You don't have to turn it into a religion, but be constantly aware of deference, to defer. Whenever a car is pulling out from a side street and I'm coming up, I always go like that. Because it's a machine, all I gotta do is just touch the accelerator, whoomp, and they're gone, and I'm still going. Whereas, if I don't do that, it means they've got to stop. Nobody wants to fucking stop. Nobody wants to stop. That's what they've got a car for, because they don't want to stop. Fine. I'm not going to interfere with their existence. So let them come. Let them come. So what you seek to do, eh, is to achieve this state of consciousness, awareness, existence that can be achieved in many ways, but one of them is called being in love. And it's the greatest energy in the world, love. There is no energy to oversee it. It's just how people misuse, abuse, distort, manipulate, and corrupt it. Keep going. Next up. Good girl. Off you go, princess. One, two. Oh, the goalkeeper will get it. There you go. Next up, please. Great ball, Jess. Off you go, Jess. This is why I do the football with the kids, because I had that experience when I was their age, 11 years old. But I have to be in the same state of mind as those kids. And I have to create enough energy whereby I can access their own infinite energy. And the only way I can do that is with the bicycle. Thank you. came to me and I stopped it and I just went bang and I pushed it to him and it went straight to his feet and he looked at me and he said, good ball, Mr. Naylor. And I was floating. We don't deal with that enough. We don't deal with that enough. We're so busy wanting to succeed. We're so busy wanting to succeed. We miss the real stuff. We miss the real stuff.